This tutorial demonstrates three things. One, an ADA implementation of an object-oriented model. Two, AUnit tests that show that the implementation of the object-oriented model is free of defects. And three, that the model does not conform to the Liskov substitution principle. As a reminder, the Liskov substitution principle, or LSP, defines a subtyping relationship called strong behavioral subtyping. They guarantee semantic interoperability of types in a class hierarchy. The principle is stated as shown. Let Q of X be a property provable about objects X of type T. Then Q of Y should be true for objects Y of type S, where S is a subtype of T. In our example, the property in question is area. T is the rectangle. And S is the square. In the class diagram, we see that a rectangle is a shape. It also appears that a square is a rectangle with regards to area. In which case, the two classes should be interoperable, that is, interchangeable. Should be able possible to swap a rectangle for a square. Under normal circumstances, we pass a unit under test to the corresponding test case, and everything works just fine. That is, a square is passed to, or rather a shape is passed to, a shape test. And a rectangle is passed to rectangle test. And a square is passed to square test. To investigate the claim that a square is a rectangle with regards to area, we pass a square posing as a rectangle to the rectangle's test case and ask it to test the area function, which is to say, we pass a square to the rectangle test. Believing the square to be a rectangle, the rectangle test sets the expected area to W times H, where W and H are different values. The rectangle test then sends the set width and set height messages to the unit under test, i.e. the square, with parameters W and H respectively, followed by a call to area. To the surprise of the test case, area returns a value equal to W squared. Since W squared is not equal W times H, the assertion obviously fails. In this way, the experiment proves that a square is not a rectangle with regards to area, and therefore, we can state that the model does not conform to the Liskov substitution principle, which was to be shown. The program used in this tutorial is object-oriented, which raises an important point when using ADA 2005. In general, where the method of implementation in a given section of code is object-oriented, the programmer should indicate this by using the object.method syntax to clearly distinguish the receiver of the method from the other parameters. Here are two examples to illustrate the point. The object method syntax, also referred to as distinguished receiver, makes the code more readable, especially to programmers coming into ADA projects with Java and C# backgrounds. Another benefit of the distinguished receiver syntax comes from the fact that we no longer have to carry the package name around. This reduces the software maintenance effort, especially when an object-oriented hierarchy is nested through several packages and a new parent class is added. All right, let's look at the source code for the application we need to test. We'll begin at the top of the class hierarchy, that is, with shape. Shape type is the top-level class. It is abstract because one of its methods is abstract, namely area. Its technical details are private. The shape access type is declared here as a courtesy for users of this class, for example, yourself in the role of a unit tester. Here we have the getters and setters for the width and height attributes. Note the presence of post conditions. With this post condition, we confirm that the width was set to W and that the height is unchanged. Likewise, here we confirm that the height was set to H and that the width is unchanged. The property area, which is computed as width times height, is true for both a rectangle and its derivative, the square. However, because the shape of a square is invariant, the square will need to fold the methods setWidth and setHeight into one. The calculation of area is implemented by the rectangle class. Area must be implemented by a subclass of shape type. And in the private part, we see, yes, that it actually contains two attributes, the width and the height. Here's the implementation of a body of shape. Rectangle. Derive a rectangle from a shape. And we attach the area method to the rectangle and confirm that the area computed by the rectangle equals width times height. Here the rectangle computes area for itself and the square, since the calculation is the same for both. Here we derive a square from a rectangle. In the implementation of square, the procedures below preserve the class invariant by constraining the width and height states of the square to be equal. In set height, the body of set width is applied to set height using renames, which provides an elegant solution to the problem of folding two independent procedures into one. Well, this concludes part one of two of the LSP tutorial. In part two, we shall examine the test code.